In this class, we are going to know about the lens law. See, in lens law, first you consider a coil which is connected to a galvanometer. So it's a galvanometer. So coil is connected to a galvanometer, and if you consider a bar magnet, if you are trying to push the bar magnet into the coil, then we know that here this bar magnet consists of some magnetic field. So whenever the magnet is trying to get into the coil, there will be change in the magnetic field lines. That means there is change in the flux. So due to the change in the flux, a current will be induced in the coil. So due to that current induced, we will have a slight deflection in this galvanometer. Galvanometer deflects slightly. And in the same way, if you are taking away, the bar magnet is taken away from the coil, then also there will be change in the flux. So due to that change in the flux, again the galvanometer deflects. But this time the galvanometer needle will deflect in another direction. That means if there is change in any magnetic field lines, that means change in any flux, then definitely there will be induced current. Induced current will be in this coil. So due to that, the galvanometer starts to deflect. If you consider a bar magnet and if you placed it inside the coil, and if the bar magnet is at rest, then there is no change in the field lines. So there is no change, there is no current produced in this coil. That means the bar magnet should be in motion. If the bar magnet is in motion, then only the induced current will be produced in the coil. If both the coil and the bar magnet are moving with same velocity in same direction, then also there will be no induced current in the coil. If the bar magnet and coil are moving with same velocity in opposite directions, then we can consider that there is some induced current in the coil. So definitely there should be some motion in opposite direction, then only there will be change in the field lines of the bar magnet, then there will be some induced current produced in the coil. And now if you consider a few situations here, first situation is, I am considering a coil here and a bar magnet. This is south pole and this is north pole. The bar magnet is coming towards the coil. Then what happens? The bar magnet is coming towards the coil. When it is coming towards it, same pole exists on the coil. So the same pole, two like poles will repel each other. That means here a repulsion force takes place. And if I consider N like this, so this will be the direction. The direction of induced current in the coil is in anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction. And consider one more situation here. A coil, a bar magnet, south and north. Now I am considering the bar magnet away from the coil. Whenever the bar magnet is moving away from the coil, then an opposite pole exhibits in the coil. The opposite pole, in the sense, there will be some attraction between these two. So attraction takes place, and the direction of induced current will be clockwise direction. Here the induced current is anti-clockwise direction, and here the induced current is clockwise direction. Now consider one more situation. It's a coil, a bar magnet. Now I am making the south pole towards the coil. If the south pole is coming towards the coil, what happens here? The same pole, when it is coming towards, the same pole exists. That means south pole. So it opposes the motion of the magnet, and here current will be induced in clockwise direction. And now you consider one more situation here. A coil, a bar magnet north and south. If the bar magnet is moving away from the coil, then what happens is an opposite pole exists here, that means north, and the induced current which is produced in this coil is in anti-clockwise direction. So these are the four different situations. By seeing all these four